Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today we are diving into something seriously powerful, the Cursor AI Code Editor. Imagine combining the best of VS Code with a super intelligent coding assistant. That's Cursor for you. Let's start with the basics, generating code for an entire project. You can just tell Cursor what you want. In this case, I want to build a simple task manager. You can mention the tech stack it should use, the features you want to have implemented, and anything specific that you want your app to have. It can generate most of the files for you by itself, but for commands to install packages or, for example, to change directory, it will ask you to manually run those. As you can see, it has started generating the files. You can go through the files one by one, review the changes and accept those, or you can accept all the files together. Now that it is done generating the files, it has also created the README file with all the instructions to run the project, which is great if you want to share this on GitHub or something. Since this is a node-based project, you need to have Node installed on your machine and then carry on with the package installations. Now, let's run it. And voila, it works. No boilerplate, no searching GitHub for starters. You can start building on top of it now. Let's try to add a task now. And it's added. The features are exactly what I asked for, with priority and status. Now, let's try to add more granular priorities to the dropdown. Just highlight the piece of code and ask Cursor to do it. You can see the changes it made, review, and accept those right on the spot. Another great feature of Cursor is Contextual Query. Got a file that's not making sense? Just ask. You can add different types of contexts and get detailed explanation from Cursor. You can refer to a piece of code, documents, past chats, web links, images to give it context and ask your questions. This is great especially when you are working with a massive project and have no idea what a certain piece of code does. Let me try to change some aesthetics by referring the markup file here. Let's accept and see the changes it made. The delete button is now red. Amazing. Next, I want to highlight the autocomplete feature of Cursor, which basically, as the name suggests, autocompletes your code as you're typing in real time. You know, just like Google search. It gives you contextual, relevant suggestions that make your code faster. Now, let's try to add dark mode to the application. Cursor already has the context of the entire project, so no need to provide additional context here. and here is the result. And it is surprisingly good too. It has a smooth transition between the dark and the light mode. Love to see that. Yeah, the statuses are colored wrong, but that's okay, a developer can easily fix that. Overall, I'm pretty impressed with Cursor so far. Cursor edits the JSX file, updates the CSS, and keeps everything intact. Next, I want to show you something different than what we have seen so far. We will now use a mockup to generate the code for it. I have this simple login page here, fields for username, password, remember me toggle, login button, and the relevant stuffs you see on a typical login page. Nothing fancy here. Now, I already have the image added as context to Cursor, so let's just write the prompt for it. And here is the result. It is very close to the mockup provided. It recognized the username and password fields. The toggle works, nice effect on the login button as well. This is great. This feature is going to be very handy to kickstart a project from a mockup, and you can go ahead and tweak as you see fit. Let's try a complex one now. I have this mockup of a tile design displaying a ton of information. So I have it added already here. Let's try to redesign the Task Manager app to this tile design. Here goes our prompt. Let's accept the changes and here we go. It follows the tile structure here, but it's just not as aesthetically pleasing, which is okay. We can be more specific with the prompt or can just fix it ourselves. The gist is that it gives the rough implementation in this case and you can always tweak going forward. Overall, I think Cursor is great. It has a ton of handy features that make coding experience smoother and better. Of course, it is not going to be perfect in certain scenarios as it is not meant to be an independent coder itself. It's just that to help you code. So all in all, it is a great AI tool for coding. That's it for this video. See you in the next one.